Everyone, like, hear me okay before I start? Okay. Right, awesome. Jejinendra and Pranam, everyone. My name is Rihi. I'm one of the education subcommittee members, and today my lightning talk is on Karuna Bhavna in practice, and more so on the implementation of Karuna Bhavna in our daily lives. So before we get into Karuna Bhavna, first we're going to backtrack a little bit, and we're going to pretty much go over what the bhavanas are and what Karuna Bhavna is specifically. So you can just click green. Yep, cool. So the bhavanas, there's actually 12 of them, and the bhavanas are defined as reflections or meditations on everyday realities of life that are intended to help people change, which is bolded, their thought processes and transform their lives. And that is the official definition according to the University of Michigan. Again, there are 12 bhavanas, but we're only going to focus on one bhavana, which is the Karuna Bhavana today. So, Karuna Bhavana refers to the idea of showing compassion to all living beings. Notice that I bolded showing because later in the lightning talk, I'm going to go over an important distinction to make when we think of Karuna Bhavna. So, when we think of Karuna Bhavna, for those of us that are familiar with it, we think about the basic things, the little things, you know, not walking on grass, not killing insects, not killing any jeev for that matter. A lot of it is centered on our actions and on our diet, but pretty much what I'm going to talk about with Karuna Bhavna, what I'm going to illustrate is a little bit deeper than that. Next slide, please. So I'm going to illustrate this with a story. It's a very basic story, but I hope it does get the point across. So it's very short too, don't worry. Also, before I get into this whole part of, or this whole spiel or part of my talk, I'm just going to give a quick disclosure slash disclaimer. Any of the people and organizations that I'm going to be talking about, not affiliated with YJA, not endorsed. YJ is not affiliated with them, so everything I say is based off of my lived experiences, and no one else's. So anyway, here goes the story. So one day after a storm, a man was walking along the beach when he noticed a boy picking up things and gently throwing them into the ocean. Approaching the boy, he asked, "Young man, what are you doing?" The boy says, "Throwing starfish back into the ocean. The surf is up and the tide is going out. If I don't throw them back, they're going to die." The man, he laughs to himself and he says, "Do you realize that there are miles and miles of beach and hundreds of starfish? Anything you do, specifically you doing this, won't make a difference." After listening politely, the boy, he bends down to pick up another starfish and he threw it back into the surf. Then he smiled at the man and he said, "I made a difference to that one." The next day, the old man gathered the local residents, and together they threw all the starfish back into the ocean. So, kind of going off of that, I'm going to talk more about it on the next slide, please. So, where does the Village of Hope come into all of this? So, the story I just told you, that story was actually shared with me by the person who founded the Village of Hope. For context, I studied abroad in Tanzania earlier this year. And on that trip, I had the incredible opportunity to visit the Village of Hope, which is an orphanage for HIV positive children. Just for context, HIV stands for human immunodeficiency virus, which is a very often deadly virus that attacks the body's immune system and ability to fight diseases. So this story was born out of the idea that anything you do, no matter how small, has a potential to have a big impact. And specifically, the person who started this Village of Hope, it was started during a time when Tanzania had rampant rates of HIV infection. A lot of these kids, they ended up without parents, they ended up sick and malnourished. And the person who founded the Village of Hope, he said to himself, "Listen, I can heal one child. If I can toss just one starfish back into the ocean, I made a difference to that one person." And when you do that, when you st when I start that, it can have a tremendous impact going forward and throughout time. And this Village of Hope, it started off with one child, and interestingly enough, 20, 30 years later, to present day, this orphanage has hundreds of kids who are thriving. These pictures are from when I visited. So you see that there's a lot of kids. You see there's buildings, there's infrastructure and institutions for these kids to succeed in life. But it all starts with one thing. So kind of going off of that, next slide, please. I'm just going to talk about some of the key takeaways that we can implement in our own lives. So number one, universality. So, or universality of Karuna Bhavna. So whether it's the boy with the starfish, whether it's the person who happens to not be a Jain, starting something like the Village of Hope, these are all key examples of Karuna Bhavna. It's about the action that you take. And you don't need to be Jain, you don't need to belong to a particular religion, to a particular ethnicity, nationality, socioeconomic class. None of those things matter because Karuna Bhavna comes from within. It's about humanity, which is something that we all have and that we all have the potential to show. And speaking of that, another key distinction I want to make is feeling versus showing. So feeling is not equated to showing compassion. So I'll illustrate this with an example. So for those of us that live in more urban areas, we tend to see a lot of the homeless population. And when we walk by them, we say, "Hey, I feel bad for them. They're often cold, starving, et cetera. They're not living in the best of conditions." And most of the time we just walk past them and not really doing anything to help them or to help their situation. But that's not true of Karuna Bhavna. The truest of Karuna Bhavna is about the bhav, that the intention that you put behind these actions and the intention that you show in showing compassion to all forms of life. So that's just an important distinction I want to make, and part of that is taking action. And building off of taking action, those small efforts do add up, kind of what I said before. Being that first person to toss the first starfish back into the water in terms of the story, or to heal that first child is a very important first step, because when you toss something into the water, it creates a ripple, and that ripple often has the potential to spread and to or to spread and to get everyone and everything around it to join in on the effort. So all it takes is one person and one person only to start the movement of showing that compassion and showing that Karuna Bhavna that we can all implement in our lives. Next slide, please. But yeah, that is my lightning talk. Thank you all for listening in, Jejinder, and Mitami Dukram. If anything I've said has offended you or has gone against teachings of Bhagwan Mahavir, and I hope you all are in good sattva, and thank you for listening to my talk tonight.